Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Most people screw up multiple percentage changes. A survey just a couple years ago with college students asked them a question about if something increases one percentage and then decreases another percentage, what's the percentage change? The majority of them got it wrong. So in today's video, I have Excel pulled up. I'm going to share this file for free. You can download it for free. You don't have to sign up for my newsletter or anything. So this is great if you're a college professor, a high school teacher teaching math, or if you just want to know how these percentage changes work. I'm going to look at four examples, and let's go ahead and dive into this right now. So here was these example, and here's why I made this video. I heard people talking, one person said, hey, our product went up 25%. And then we decreased it 25%, and the other person said, oh, you broke even. No, you lost. Here's my example. If something cost $8 and it's a 25% increase, that's $2 more. So 8 and 2 is 10. And then a 25% decrease from $10 is $7.50. So 7.5. divided by 8 minus 1 is negative 6.25%. So a lot of people just get percentages, multiple percentages wrong. So let's show you the formula here to do this. Example number one, we're going to have increase followed by an increase. The first increase is 30%. The second increase is 10%. So a little bit of Excel skills, alt equal. So we're saying, hey, that's going to be a 40% increase. No. Here is the math formula to figure this out. It is not an Excel function. An Excel function is average, max, large, sum. No words are involved. It's just purely a formula. Equals that number plus the second number plus you. Technically don't have to do the open print, but I like to. The first number times the second number, it just keeps it a little cleaner for me. There is your math formula sitting right there in cell B7. Control enter. So that would be a 43% increase. We're going to test it down below at the bottom and use some Excel skills. So now that I've got a formula in cell B6, it's in the formula bar. I've got a formula in cell B7. Again, it's in the formula bar. Example two is a decrease followed by a decrease. So here we go again. Notice I put in negative 25% and negative 25%. It doesn't matter what the percentages are. That would be a 44% decrease. And here's my example. When I say it doesn't matter what the percentages are, I'm going to do negative 0.45. So that's not a 70% decrease, it is 59. I'm gonna just put undo and get it back to 25. So now, one more time, autofill crosshairs. We have an increase followed by a decrease, but overall this is gonna be an increase. So this one's interesting. I'm gonna pull this first one over. A lot of people would say, oh, that's gonna be a 40% increase overall. No, watch this. It is only a 6% increase. And again, we're about to test it. And I'll just pull this over one more time. Same example as number three, increase followed by decrease. But we end up, instead of having a 15%, something went up 60% and then it went down 45. No, that is not a 15% increase. That is a 12% decrease. That was very similar to my $8, 25% increase is 10, 25% down is 750. Here we go with some Excel features down below just to test these numbers. It doesn't matter what your starting number is. I'm going to use the number 200. You type whatever you want to in cell B11. Here's a 3D reference. The first number is equal to cell B4. So 200 times 30% is 60. Again, I'm just using formulas. The 60 plus the 200, I called this subtotal 1 down on row number 14. We only have to do this one time. The second number, again, is going to be a 3D reference, equals cell B5. So therefore, what's the change there? The 260 times 10% is an additional 26. That is going to drive me crazy, so let me fix that. So therefore, the total is the 26 plus the 260, should get 286. Again, I'll fix that, so it's correcting the file when you get it. Yes, there we go. So the percentage change is the 286 divided by the 200 minus 1. This will be your percentage change. There you go. 43% equals 43%, that same formula that I showed you. So now that I've got these filled in here, I can just simply, everything's a formula, pull over to the right, test my numbers, negative 44, negative 44, 6%, 6%, 12 and 12. There you go, right there. And again, when I say it doesn't matter what the numbers are, they went to 201, 202, and 203. I don't care if this number is 500, 180, 60. It doesn't matter what the numbers are to start off with. We're doing multiple percentages. So hopefully this helps. It drives me crazy when I hear people get this wrong, but now that you know how it works, there's your formula. Next time you're in a department store and you've got that 20% off coupon and they have a special, everything's already 20% off and you get an additional 20% off, that is not 40% off. You can go figure it out now with your calculator. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe. Please give me a comment if you like this video. And this file, the download will be in the description down below, right after my little introduction description. Thank you for your time. Take care.